Hi, I'm Iain Anderson, and in this video, part of a series, I'll be showing you how to choose between the different motion tracking selection options available in Mocha, and also how to work with shape keyframes. I'm in Final Cut Pro with this Combi Van clip on a timeline. I've applied the Continuum Gels effect to a clip, and I've pressed Mocha Mask to isolate the effect. In this clip, I could use one of a few tools to make a selection, so I'll use the X-Spline tool to create a quick shape here. There's only one layer here, but each layer can be set to track with translation, or you can add scaling, rotation, skewing, or perspective. When you click one option here, all the options to the left are turned on too. All the options up to skew are on by default, and usually this will work well. But depending on the movement that the tracked area will undergo, and how well it tracks the first time you try, you might need to switch some of these options on or off. In some circumstances, you might choose to also activate perspective, but it is off by default. Skew is probably the best choice for tracking organic, stretchy objects. But if you're tracking a flat, rigid object that's moving in three dimensions, like the side of this fan, and the track isn't perfect, you might want to turn on perspective here and try tracking again. Once you've tracked, you can still work with the shape, and you can adjust it at any point in time. The first shape you drew, and any other frames at which you change the shape, will each become a shape keyframe, remembering that modified shape. So, if I pull out this point at this frame early in the clip, it's going to make a shape keyframe, and it will now animate the shape as it plays towards the other shape keyframe where I drew the shape in the first place. Note that it still maintains the tracking data. Mocha's shape animation always builds off the tracking data, which is why a good track is so important. If you want to take this further, you can jump between these shape keyframes with these two arrow buttons. And you can delete the active shape keyframe by pressing this key minus button. To complete this shot, I'll also need to track the back panel of the van on a separate layer and also using perspective. When you start using multiple layers, you may want to explore the classic workspace. Up next! Thanks for watching, and see you soon!